Alright, we are in Mos Entha. It might be a little bit hard to tell because all these starports look exactly the same, but we're in Mos Entha. Oh, we got like a droid fixing a terminal here. That's cool. Alright, so Anqui is just outside the starport, luckily. And she's up on this little raised bit of dirt. That's odd. Anyways. Hey, Anqui. You look like a racer. What can I do for you? Lalo said you might know where a certain droid motivator might be located. Why would I know anything about a droid motivator? You said you knew someone that used it to help him run a pod racer through an old track. Pod racing is illegal. Of course it is. So you don't know any racers, not even swoop racers. Maybe. Talk to Drakness about running some test tracks. If you finish them, we'll see about any droid motivators we might have lying around. I can do that. Tell me where he is. We can find him here. Okay. Alright, so we're actually gonna run some races. That's cool. I kind of regret using that F-Zero music for that one part that other time. Anyway, speak to Drakness. He's 100 meters this way. And I'm feeling lazy, so let's use our speeder bike. That's another gong droid. Yes. There needs to be gong droids all over the place. You never have enough gong droids. Hey, Drakness.
Anqui says you can race, Crunchbar. I'll have to see for myself. I don't know you, so I'm going to give you an easy race. It will not take long, and you will see soon enough if you can follow the course.
That won't be a problem.
Excellent. At least you talk as if you were a spear pilot. We shall soon see, you know?
Let's go, Drakness. I want to race now.
As you wish, Crunchbar.
Check in with the race timer to start race. Okay. So I get to use race music. That's awesome. I'll have to see what race music I can fit in. I already have one song in mind, but I don't think... Ah! Where'd you come from? You half-imperial, half-speeder-bike hybrid you. Come on, just finish your search. Finish your search.
Move along.
Yeah, move along. They may or may not have used that, taken that sound clip from the movie. I'm not sure, because that sound clip kind of sounds out of place. It's like the one single piece of, voice acting that they have in the entire game. Aside from the, beginner station. Alright, let's scoot our speeder bike up a little bit. Save as much time as we can before we start the race. RC-1Z. Are you ready to start the race? Yes. Begin. Oh shoot. Go, go, go! We just barely made that. At least a couple of those checkpoints. On one checkpoint, we had like 1 second left. I mean, holy crap. You are marked as successfully completing this race. Speak to your race giver for your next race. Goodbye. Good luck, sir. Okay. That's all. Return to Jack. That is a big lizard. That's a dragon man. Okay. Anyways. Let's return to Drakness. I think what I'm gonna do for these Ithorians, like, since they have, like, two throats and two mouths, which are, like, on the sides of their head, you might not know that. I'll show you when we return to Drakness. Yeah, you see that slit on the side of his head? That's a mouth. And he has one over here. He has one over here, too. So he has two mouths. He speaks in... Ithorians speak in stereo, actually. So that's interesting. So I think what I'm going to do for, like, whenever I speak for these Ithorians, is I'm going to, like, have them speak double. I'm going to edit it somehow. I'll see how it turns out.
Congratulations, Crunchbar. You have completed the first race. As I indicated earlier, the race was only a beginner's test.
I'm guessing you have more races in store for me.
At least one more.
Another test? Why don't we get to the real thing?
This race is a bit more difficult than the first. You may need to repeat it.
Oh, okay. Alright, race of navigation. But, that's awesome, Gonk Droid. Gonk. But before we do that, I think I'm gonna buy a better speeder. This one just isn't cutting it. We barely made that last test, and that was like the beginner's test. So yeah, let's try to find the bazaar around here and see if we can buy. Where's the bazaar? Oh, the bazaar is to our south. There it is. So we're gonna go ahead and buy a new speeder. And this one's fast? That's not fast enough. We need more speed. So let's check the bazaar. Better location. No, let's check the auctions. I'm used to checking the vendor location. Because it used to be that vendors were the only thing that you could find, like, items reliably. But I guess they changed it so that now you can, like, sell your crap on the bazaar. For good prices, actually. The Sin Mokhni Swoop. Alright, so let's go ahead and get the waypoint to that. And let's go buy ourselves a swoop bike. Where is that? Let's zoom out so we can see. Am I able to zoom out? I should be able to zoom out more than that. Anyways, looks like it's way over here. So I will cut to me getting there. Alright, so we have entered the metropolis of Practically Tactical. That is a very interesting city name. And yeah, this is a player city. Looks very nice. We got a diner here, the Parsec Diner. We have, of course, the very elaborate housing. This is actually a very nice-looking city. I commend whoever built the city. The ship shop. This is like another interesting building, the hangar bay. Anyways, oh, there's the Jabba's barge house again. Anyways, we are not here to take the tour of this lovely metropolis. We are here to head on over to this vendor. Alright, so we are here in the township of Palace Courtyard. And we're about to enter the Jabba Mart 2. I guess there was a Jabba Mart 1 somewhere. Anyways, let's go ahead and go in here. And let's introduce the concept of vendors. Well, once this, once the interior of this place loads in. Or is this the interior and, like, the vendors just on the lower floor? I'm not sure. Oh, nope. Okay. Now, finally, the interior loads in.
Glory to the Emperor.
Ah. What's going on? Huh. Interesting. So, let's go back upstairs. I think the vendor's upstairs. Ah! Wow. Oh look, it's a space station model. That's cool. And we have like a fountain that's like spewing brown stuff. I'm not really sure what that's supposed to be. It looks like, I know, it's like a chocolate fountain, but yeah. I'm not sure what to say about that. Anyways. Well, that's a nice painting. Nim's Revenge. You got the pirate Nim there. It's cool. This is a very elaborate house. We got like rare paintings all over the place. We got just all sorts of things. Anyway, that's cool. Let's talk to, is it this person? Are you the, person who sells vehicle deeds, good sir? No, you're not. Or are you the person who sells deeds? No, you are not. Are you? Sammy Stuff Seller? Yes, you are. So, we'll just, go ahead and buy a swoop bike from you. There we go. And now it's time to,
There are two types of pilots. Those that fly through Beggar's Canyon, and those who fly over using a droid pilot. Guess which one I am.
Huh. So I guess there's, more voice acting in this game than I thought there were. Thought there was. That's interesting. So let's, go ahead and pull out our new swoop bike. There we go. And this is the much faster swoop bike, whereas our last speeder was just the speeder bike. Let's go ahead and remove that. And this is the fastest mount in the game, once it gets up to speed. Where to now? Let's go back to Practically Tactical and head on back to Mos Entha. Anyways, this is the fastest mount in the game. It's also like, and because of that, it's also like cheapest. As you saw, I only had to pay 900 credits for this. Like because it's the fastest, you know. Obviously, it's the most widespread, and you know, because there's so many of them, you have to sell them cheap in order to sell them at all. Supply and demand, you know. All right, we crashed, but we're back here in Mos Entha anyways. So let's just hop onto our brand new speeder bike, our swoop bike, I mean. And I think this is the swoop bike that this is like the vehicle that Anakin used when he like went out to search for his mom. I think this is that same speeder bike. I might be mistaken. It looks familiar though. And the speeder bike I was using earlier was obviously the one from what's it called? Episode 6. RC2X. As those, as that rebel was being chased by a stormtrooper. In a very Benny Hill fashion. Anyways, let's start this race. Are you ready to start the race? Yes. Begin. Okay. Alright, let's show this race who's boss. God, where do I go? Okay, through here. We could have done this in our speeder bike. That wasn't hard. I mean, it was a little disorienting, but yeah, whatever. That was easy. You are marked as successfully completing this race. Speak to your race giver for your next race. Goodbye. Good luck, sir. I'm gonna speak to Drakness again for our next race. Oh boy. Let's hope it's a little bit more challenging than that one. That was easy, Drakness. What the hell?
Well done. That was fine work.
Thank you. You have any other challenges for me?
Indeed I do. One final race. It will test you more than either of the first two races. You will do well to complete it on your first try.
No problem. Just point me to the race timer.
One with such bravado has no need of luck. But I wish it to you regardless.
Okay. Final race. So apparently this race is more challenging than the previous two combined. Or something. Alright, let's scoot on over there and start this. Where's this place? The place looks suspiciously like the Lucky Depot. Lucky Despot. Oh no, apparently it's the Fallen Star. It just so happens that there are two cities on this planet that had huge-ass ships crash into them and then turn into cantinas. Anyways, this is one of those droids that has like a bug head. Are you ready to start the race? Yes. Begin. Okay. Alright, let's go. Let's go. Oh, it's another inner city race. This shouldn't be too hard then. Wasn't hard. Too fast. Okay. Alright.
You are marked as successfully completing this race. Greet to your race quit.
We already know.
Good luck, sir.
Turn to Drakness. What the hell, Drakness? The first race was like the hardest. It's like, the one that I just completed was like, the second hardest, but the first one was easily the hardest, considering there was a point when I only had 1 second left, and just barely got through it. Alright, Darkness. What do you have to say for yourself?
It appears you are quite the racer after all. Please return to Enquay with my compliments. Your tests were quite entertaining.
So you'll tell her that I'm a good racer?
I will, and more. You have done well today, Crunchbar.
Great. I'll head back to her.
I will call her that you're going to be arriving. Tell her how much I enjoy your exciting races.
They sure were exciting.